The last Saras high-speed taxi trial was completed on 20th May 2004. After this trial, the DGCA formally cleared Saras for its first flight. The Saras was finally ready to fly. The action now shifted to the telemetry tower and room. Sitting in this room, the flight management team would be in constant touch with the test pilots and monitor every aspect of the first flight.
Tango string 5.
Tango tower taken 108, established on local
of the flight director. This is from the administration point of view. And he has to clear the next test point, as they call it. So that there has to be one person who has to give the go-ahead for the next point and use his judgment and experience to say that, okay, that's fine, you can go ahead. Because when you are doing flight testing, you get some results which you didn't expect.
On 28 May 2004, the full Saras team met to review the first flight plan. Every aspect of the flight test plan was discussed in great detail. The pilots, without any trace of emotion, announced that they were now fully prepared to fly.
I had been with the team all along, and there was nothing. It was just another day's work as far as we were concerned.
The big day had finally come. As the pilots made their pre-flight checks, the tension was palpable. The first flight was now only a few minutes away. As the test pilots entered the aircraft, they received warm words of encouragement from their commandant.
The level of confidence is directly related to the preparatory work that has gone. Now we in AST for the last 3 years before the flight were closely associating with the designers and also thereafter at the manufacturing stage. And our pilots had felt and touched the aircraft in every system at different stages. The preparation level for the first flight has to be 110%. And that 110% preparation had actually taken place.
The Saras engines roared as the aircraft taxied out and moved to the main runway. At 8:20 a.m., Squadron Leader Venugopal sought the Flight Test Director's permission to begin rolling. Later, the Saras was finally airborne. It was a magical moment.
It was a momentous day. I'll never forget it because not every pilot, every test pilot gets an opportunity to fly the prototype first flight in his life. I think I was inordinately fortunate to get this. It was a normal routine action as far as we were concerned. Self and Max, both of us got into the aeroplane. We were seen off by the crew, and we started up. Engine parameters were all normal. Engine was beautiful. Response was good. The temperatures were nice. Weather was beautiful, like it is today, nice and sunny. And we taxied out. We found that the two vehicles that invariably chase us were with us. So we had done this so many times. So at no stage during the taxiing out, the weight of that, the gravity of the situation kind of ever, it came on me.
Saras flew for about 25 minutes, attaining a height of 7,000 feet and speeds of up to 250 kilometers per hour. It was a practically flawless first flight.
We went hardly about 15-20 kilometers south, and we went further east. it is normal procedure because we can't land the aeroplane off a short approach. We had to do a long stay.
At 8:45 a.m., Saras, accompanied by two IAF aircraft, prepared to land. An instant later, Saras landed. The mood after the first flight was euphoric. There was loud applause, there were handshakes and hugs. Champagne corks popped open. The Indian tricolour was waved with pride and joy. Dr. B.R. Pai, NAL's director, was visibly delighted. The air was rent with the beautiful music of success. The test pilots were relieved. First flight is always a very severe test.
Flying an aeroplane for the very first time, that type of aeroplane having never been flown before, is a thing, very special thing. Because you have, other than ground estimates based on calculations and judgment and whatever, of course wind tunnel testing and all that, there's a lot of data available on ground. But you don't quite know how much of it will be precisely what we expect in the end.
It was a sense of happiness, elated, sense of accomplishment. Maybe a job well done.
And Professor Narsimha, who waited 15 years to see the Saras fly, was overjoyed.
Overjoyed. In fact, I'm very happy. It's a landmark in the history of Indian civil aeronautics. Because it demonstrates India has ambitions in making civil aircraft.
Dr. Prahlad, who led the Saras program so skillfully, could hardly contain his joy.
Well, it is very difficult to describe in concrete words. It is something inside you felt, oh, what a great thing. Something that we have done after so many years of work.
The successful Saras flight was widely hailed in the media, but this was only the beginning. The road ahead was going to be long and difficult. The Saras flew again on 7 June and 19 July. Saras undercarriage was retracted for the first time during the third flight. The flight test program continued in August with flights on 18th, 19th and 20th August 2004.
So basically as a pilot we are taught from the day one to handle all emergencies. We have our actions taped up and we are prepared for any eventuality.
Both the test pilots were now coming to terms with the aircraft.
I found that the aeroplane was very responsive. Normally, transport aeroplanes don't have that kind of response. It's only a fighter that follows your input. Here we found that the aeroplane following each input.
The Saras inaugural flight took place on 22nd August 2004. A large and distinguished gathering, including the Minister of State for Science and Technology, was present to witness this flight. Despite some turbulence, the test pilots flew straight and low, much to everyone's delight.
Once we lined up, opened par, as I would say, the noise level was slightly less as compared to other aircraft. The acceleration was good. In no time, we were touching about 70 knots, 80, 100, 105. We unstuck. This was a great feeling, actually.
The successful inaugural flight evoked great jubilation and pleased every Indian. Saras has now passed its first test. Saras does indeed appear to be a very good aircraft.
It's got a reasonably good cockpit, comfortable cockpit. It's got a reasonably good visibility. It's the right sort of size to be comfortable. It's not a very huge one. So it's endearing to the pilot that way, the moment you look at it. And it has got a moderate, modest performance, not a high-speed aeroplane. Very nice engines. Very nice engines. Cockpit instrumentation is good. Excellent. I think generally seating comfort and the view and now the ground control after some improvements, of course, is good. A nice little aeroplane in this class.
But there are sterner challenges ahead.
The first flight gives the confidence to the manufacturer and so much more to the designer and the pilot that aeroplane is safe and can get airborne safely. So many more milestones have still to be achieved. But the manner in which everybody is working together with Synergy, I have no doubt that we are going to succeed, and we are going to succeed quickly.
A second prototype has to be readied. The flight test schedule will be extremely rigorous.
Start the real hardcore flight testing, where we get data from each flight, and analyze data, and then go towards certification.
The biggest challenge ahead is to ensure that Saras is successfully certified by DGCA.
Expect the later half of 2007, another 2.5 years, because it will depend a lot on the second prototype also for the certification flights.
Thereafter, Saras will have to be aggressively marketed.
I think it's getting to be in place. It's not yet completely in place because civil aviation poses different challenges. First place, if you make an aircraft, you can't ask the airlines to do it. It's not like, in some of these projects, in principle, there's a launch customer, which is the Indian Air Force. In this case, we may not have a launch customer.
The dream of seeing hundreds of Saras aircraft flying in Indian skies is still a few years away. We will get there. Saras has proved once again that when India is determined, it always succeeds.
I would like to see hundreds of them flying in Indian and other skies.